So once again, we want to give all praises to the Most High, Yahweh, Basham, Yahushai. Say double honors to the elders at Great Millstone that rule well.
Can.
And all well. The brothers, you know, who pushing this word in sincerity and in truth. Who doing it out there, you know? The heart now, but who really led by the Spirit. Say Shalom.
Shalom.
You know? We just have a few scriptures just to go through here to really show that it's really important for us to be into the scriptures and get the knowledge of the scriptures correct so we could speak the truth now.
Can.
Understand? And we are not children of the night, I like to say now, you know? And we don't like darkness that it has other Israelite groups that push away the day of evil. Understand? So we like to speak the truth now, the 100% truth, because it's very important according to the scriptures.
Can.
Understand? Because we can't talk about our head. We have to be led by the Holy Spirit to go through the scriptures and bring out the truth.
Can.
Whether if it's sweet, whether if it's sour, you know, it's 100% truth.
Can.
Understand? The first scripture we go through is Matthew. Matthew 15 verse 11.
Yeah. Matthew chapter 15 verse 11.
Yeah. No, that's not Matthew 15. Yeah. Sure? I start with the surah. This is surah. Chapter 33 verse 4. You see here, prepare what to say, and so thou shalt be heard, and bind up instructions, and then make answer. Understand? So everything what we supposed to do, like when we go, before we go, they we supposed to, you know, let the Holy Spirit really prepare us now.
Can.
Understand? So we suppose that we're supposed to be studying, supposed to be doing research, we're supposed to be keeping our eyes open upon the news.
Can.
You know, watching and fulfillment of prophecies, being occupied in prophecies.
Can.
That we're really supposed to be doing. That is our job. So when we go all day, we can always give the truth, the 100% truth. And understand?
Break down the scriptures properly.
So so with that now we could go into Matthew. Matthew 15:11.
This is Matthew chapter 15 verse 11.
Yeah.
Not that which goeth into the mouth defileth a man.
Yeah.
But that which cometh out of the mouth, this defileth a man.
This defileth a man. So when Yahweh made that statement, it was for the wicked Pharisees and them, really. Wicked Pharisees and them that, you know, that always had a thing at the point they say, why the man and them then wash their hands and thing and they started eat and thing, and the Mosiah Yahweh Basham Yahushai, the Mosiah Yahweh had to rebuke them and reprove them and say, hey, it's not that defile a man. It's what comes out, defile a man. You understand? So whatever you're teaching, it's supposed to be 100% truth, because if it's not truth, it will defile you. You understand? Because the man, right now the Most High making us with the truth, kind of like a kingdom now, boy. like a priesthood. Like what the scripture says, a kingdom, a priesthood, right?
Mm-hmm.
He making us a kingdom, a priesthood. But the scripture says a priest looks supposed to keep the truth. Understand? So you get to that too. Malachi 2 verse 7.
Yeah, this is Malachi chapter 2 verse 7.
Yeah.
For the priest's lips should keep knowledge.
For the priest's lips, so we are preparing to be the kingdom of priesthood to the Most High. So how are we supposed to do by that? How are we supposed to be ready for that? We're supposed to always be keeping the truth. Understand? So because we will be the kingdom of priesthood unto the Most High.
Yeah.
Understand? Continue.
And they should seek the law,
yeah,
at his mouth.
At his mouth.
For he is the messenger of Yahweh of hosts.
He is the messenger. You understand? So, and in order to be a messenger of the Most High, you have to be led by the Spirit of the Most High.
Can.
You understand? According to I think it's Romans 8 verse 14. I'm gay because it's real important. This truth is real important because you're not supposed to be teaching any other thing other than the truth now. Understand? This is Romans chapter 8 verse 14. It says, for as many as are led by the Spirit of the Most High, they are the sons of the living power.
Yeah.
Understand? So we are the sons of the Most High. Understand? He bringing back us into the our state of our royal priesthood. Understand? So our lips are always supposed to keep the knowledge. Always supposed to keep the truth. You understand? We're not supposed to be keeping silent. We're not supposed to be, you know, teaching other doctrines and being caught up in other doctrines. You understand? Strictly truth. 100% truth, whether it good, whether it bad. You understand? We're not putting off no day or no evil. As a matter of fact, we need time of prophecies, and we're saying death to America still.
That's right.
Death to the wicked kingdom. Gun. Death to the two-thirds.
Gun.
You understand? Because that is the prophecies what we're going to be fulfilled right now. We're just waiting for the mark of the beast, the chip to be mandatory, and all hell going to start to break loose.
Gun.
You understand? We're not hiding, you know, no day or no evil and sweeten up nothing for nobody. You're not changing my ways. 100% truth.
So all of them who have faith in this system, all they're going to die.
Yeah,
so
this is Surah chapter 5. Yes, this is Surah 5. Yeah, chapter 5 verse 13. He said, honor and shame is in talk, and the tongue of man is his fall.
Hmm.
Right? The reason why the most I say the tongue of man is his fall now, boy. By what is saying, because remember your tongue is a little member, it could kindle real fire now, boy, you know? According to James, right? Whatever you speak, that will defile you. Hmm. If you're not speaking according to the truth and according to the knowledge, then it's not of the most high.
Good.
You understand? Because First Corinthians 4:11.
Yeah, this is First Corinthians chapter 4 verse 11.
That's not yeah. No, First Peter Salaki. First Peter 4:11. Salaki.
Yeah.
You understand? Because the men of the most high, if you wanna check it back out, all the other men who all the prophets who was before us, the foundation what was building on Yahushai. Understand the Yahushai kingdom. Now you can't come and build no other doctrine on this king and on this foundation.
Can.
Understand? Bring it out now.
Yeah, 1 Peter 4 verse 11.
Mm-hmm.
If any man speak, let him speak as the oracles of Yahweh.
Yeah.
If any man minister, yeah, let him do it as of the ability which Yahweh giveth.
Ability of which the Most High give it. Now you can't get that just so the Most High have to give you that, because when you go out on the highways and the byways, right, we already ministering. We already ministering and giving out the testimony of your Most High, which is the truth. Yeah, that's what I say, yeah. Which is the truth. You can't mix the truth. The truth is the truth. You can't lie again. You can't mix truth.
With like just like how you can mix this knowledge or the Yahweh Hashem Yahushai with the world, you can't mix them.
Like water and oil.
Yeah, it don't mix. It can't merge at all. It can't be wanting the things of the world or being in the world and also this truth.
Understand? So it's really important for you to speak the truth now, boy. You know, and why we in Surah, one time, I'm going to read verse 4, right? Chapter 4, is it Surah 4? Verse 23. Say, and refrain not to speak when there is occasion to do good, and hide not thy wisdom in her beauty. Right? And the wisdom as well. Knowledge and understanding of the scriptures.
Mm-hmm.
You're not supposed to hide that in the beauty now, boy, because when you're ready, when the Most High put that spirit upon you, that when your light shining in beauty, so you're not supposed to hide the wisdom, you're supposed to speak now, boy. You know? But notice what he say in the before you say that, you say where there is occasion to do good. You understand? We're not saying as a thing you run and tell everybody.
Yeah.
We're not on that. Spirit of discernment, you will know the Most High will set people up to come and hear.
Yeah.
You understand what I'm saying? When it spread upon you, do videos, do things, push out that word. You understand now that we're talking about now, you know? For by speech wisdom shall be known. You understand? So that we're not supposed to keep silent no time. And learning by the word of the tongue. You understand? So even though the scriptures say no man can tame the tongue. But well, when the spirit of the Most High put that spirit upon you, you are no less even shock yourself. When you put that video upon you and you watching your own video, you know, say, but you do that?
Yeah, sometimes you break down something or you say something and you're saying, wait, I really break down like that, boy?
Yeah, sir. Because the spirit has been upon you, so you have to be led. You understand? You have to be led according to Romans 8 verse 14. It says, "Therefore, as many as are led by the Spirit of the Most High, they are the sons of the Most High." You understand? So the priests, and when you go under the highways and the byways to minister unto the people, you're supposed to be led now, boy. You understand? You're not supposed to be teaching no other doctrine but the truth.
Good.
You understand? And they, Exodus 19 verse 6. Because we're going back to the statement I make, because we're really coming back to the kingdom of priesthood to the Most High.
Yeah.
Understand?
This is Exodus chapter 19 verse 6.
Mm-hmm.
"And ye shall be unto me a kingdom of priests."
Yeah, kingdom of priests. So you read in Malachi what a priest lips supposed to be that way. Supposed to be always, the lips supposed to be always be speaking the truth then.
Done.
And the knowledge supposed to be in the lips. Continue.
"And the holy nation."
Yeah.
"These are the words which thou shalt speak unto the children of Israel."
You understand? Unto the children of Israel. You understand? James 3 verse 5 and 6. Because to tell you the honest truth, you just feel a joy to be doing videos.
What?
After you do videos and things, you just feel a joy when you know. No matter if you get one, you can get one view, you can get two views. But you know what? The Most High still putting that spirit upon me, because you never know who could see a video.
Okay.
You never know who could be up on YouTube and actually see a video, and you could wake up somebody like that now. You understand?
And not even doing a video alone, but just like putting together precepts to do a video, feel real good, buddy.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
James 3.
Yeah. Verse 5.
Yeah.
Hey, James 3, verse 5.
Uh-huh.
"Even so, the tongue is a little member, and boasted great things."
Yeah.
"Behold, how great a matter a little fire kindled."
Yeah, how great a matter. And he was not saying that there, because your tongue is the most powerful thing on your body. Your tongue is the most powerful thing in your body. But scripture said life and death is in the power of the tongue. Mm. Understand? So what we go do? The power of the tongue, and we have the power of the tongue, but so you know what we go do? We go say by faith, this wicked kingdom will fall. By faith, you understand? And the will of Yahweh Ba'asham Yahushai, this Babylonian system, what people want to hold on to will fall that way.
Done.
Understand? Death to America. Death to the two-thirds.
Done.
You understand?
Death to all of them who want to be proud. The secular scripture say, pride goes before a fall.
You understand? That's not whole of James, and go to Ephesians 4, verse 29. But the timing is so near.
Ephesians
4:29. But this is real. This is one of the scriptures supposed to hold fast, and that's hard scripture here, because it's one of the nicest scriptures. Well, to me, why all the scriptures nice, you know, but this one is our standout one. Yeah, understand? Kingdom of priesthood, supposed to be talking the truth. The lips supposed to, you know, be honoring the Most High.
There is Ephesians chapter 4 verse 29.
Yeah.
"Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth."
Yeah.
"But that which is good to the use of edifying."
To the use of edifying. Right? Going out on the highways and byways and putting up videos and doing the works, it's always, at the end of the day, it's for edification. You understand? And edification to who? To the people like Israel. First and foremost now, the people like Israel, right? And the elect. "Let no corrupt communication." A corrupt communication is come like a lie. A corrupt communication you're mixing the truth with other false doctrine. That is corrupt communication. Teaching only 50% and 60% of the truth is corrupt communication. You understand? Because right now you're like a poor watchman then.
Yeah.
You understand? You're not telling the people exactly what's coming. But we're telling them exactly what's coming.
Yeah, just like one of them pastors in the so-called churches, in the heart houses.
Yeah. Continue, finish it now.
Yeah. Verse 29.
Yeah.
Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth, but that which is good to the use of edifying, that it may minister grace unto the hearers.
Unto the hearers. You understand? So the Most High will always have his people. It have a way the Most High does work. If he's a elect, or if he was meant to be in this world, you understand? The Most High will guide you. You understand? And when this city be like the men of the Most High preaching this word on the highways and byways, you understand? I think that I am Isaiah 30. Oh, I've got this plenty of scripture that's running through my head right now. Now, boy, yeah. Right, this is Isaiah chapter 30, verse 20. He says, and though the Most High gave you the bread of adversity and the water of affliction, yet shall not thy teachers be removed into a corner anymore. Understand? So the teachers is who? The men who pushing this word in sincerity and in truth.
Okay.
Understand? The men who is led by the Spirit of the Most High, how about Shammai or Shai to break down the scriptures. Understand? And them as the teachers now, boy, and they won't be hit no more. You understand? And one example is that, like, that doing those videos.
Can.
You understand? Because I think Apostle Tahan and break down the internet now. When the box and the phone man open. You understand? We have access to the internet now.
The unicorn.
You understand? The unicorn. So you say, yet shall not thy teachers be removed into a corner anymore, but thy eyes shall see thy teachers. So you will see the men of the Most High. You will actually see them.
Okay.
You understand? And thy ear shall hear a word behind thee saying, this is the way, walk ye in it. When you turn to the right hand and when you turn to the left. Because and plenty of the brothers wake up like that. They started hearing the word and like, nah boy, this had to be the truth.
Okay.
This had to be it. This had to be the truth.
Okay.
You understand? So that would have never happened if the Most High, if the men and them was teaching false doctrine. You understand? Because when they teach false doctrine, doctrine, plenty does gather. False doctrine attract plenty, like crowd now. False doctrine because they like sweet things to hear.
But look at the other houses.
Yeah, you understand? It does attract the majority. You understand? But you know what? The Most High what? The small,
a remnant.
A remnant now, boy. But you know what the remnant has? The remnant has quality. Yeah, that's how the Most High do with quality, not quantity.
Can.
They do with quality. Yeah, that's how. So the priest of the, so when we turn into the priest of the, a priest to the Most High, we're supposed to be always picking the truth. And that's how I'm, Proverbs 18 verse 21.
This is Proverbs chapter 18, verse 21.
Yeah.
Death and life are in the power of the tongue.
Death and life is in the power of the tongue. Continue.
And they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof.
They shall love it, shall eat the fruit thereof. So if you like, if you love life, and you want to live spiritually, you understand? You'll be speaking the truth, and you'll be actually hearing the word, because if a man do not speak the truth in you, right? If you, and you start to take up this false doctrine, What will eventually what will happen to you? You will die spiritually. Because he's not speaking the truth. Understand? But when he speak the truth, now you live. When he hear the truth, also you live. You live. You understand? And just to close off, that's two more precepts. My Proverbs 12, 17 to 9. And Proverbs 13, verse 3.
Proverbs 12, 17 to 9, you're saying?
17 to 19, so lucky.
Proverbs 12, chapter 12, verse 17.
Yeah.
He that speaketh truth sheweth forth righteousness.
He that what?
Speaketh truth.
He that what?
Speaketh truth.
He that speaketh truth. Continue.
Sheweth forth righteousness.
Sheweth forth righteousness. Because the Most High never gave us a spirit of fear, right? But he also never gave the men and them a spirit of lies too. You can't go down there and speak lies and then calling upon the Most High.
Mm.
Understand? So we're supposed to speak the truth at all times now, boy. And that will show us what our show forth righteousness. Understand? And now I am we're supposed to be clothed with garments, right? But not the physical garments. The garments is righteousness now. It's the knowledge and the word of the knowledge of the truth now. Yeah. The wisdom of the truth, the garments now. Understand? Continue.
But a false witness deceit.
But a false witness deceit. So when other people, like everybody else, other than pushing this word sincerity and in truth, there's false witness. So they're speaking deceit. They're speaking lies. Continue.
Verse 18. There is that speaketh like the piercings of a sword.
Yeah.
But the tongue of the wise is health.
The tongue of the wise is health. So that's why you go back into the scripture with when you say Proverbs 18:21, say life and death is in the power of the tongue. You understand? But here what you say here, but the tongue of the wise is health. So when it's healthy, you will live.
Okay.
Understand? If you're healthy spiritually, you will live. You understand? Continue.
Verse 19.
Mm-hmm.
The lip of truth shall be established forever.
But the lip of the truth will be established forever. And who are the lip of the truth? Going back to the what? The priesthood of the Most High. Because the Most High will make a royal priesthood. You understand? And them will last forever now, boy. The truth will always last forever. You understand? Mm. Come on.
But a lying tongue is but for a moment.
A lying tongue is but for a moment. So all these churches and all these other philosophies, they're just for a moment.
And all those other camps.
They're just for a moment.
And GMS.
You understand? So called when Jacob troubled rich. And Jacob troubled rich. And all the other Jakes and them who wasn't really, you know, who follow these other philosophies. You want to see them bumped out. You understand? And now, last thing I want to say, Proverbs 13. Proverbs 13, verse 3.
Yeah, like Proverbs chapter 13, verse 3. He that keepeth his mouth, keepeth his life.
Yeah.
But he that openeth wide, his lips shall have destruction.
His lips shall have destruction. Understand? So whoever keepeth his mouth, you understand? So that's why, yes, we're supposed to be out there and preaching the word, right? But we only supposed to be preaching the truth. Anything other than the truth. You understand? Will lead to destruction. Anything other than the truth leading to destruction.
Yeah.
For point blank. Point blank. Without no getting around it. You understand? So that is a short deal thing we put together to let the people and them know, but the brothers and them know too, even the young brothers who are now coming in too, that it's very important for you to be speaking the truth at all times.
Can.
Not supposed to butter up nothing for nobody. We just tell it how it is, the raw truth. You understand? Because the Most High bring back us to have a kingdom of priesthood, and according to the scriptures, Malachi 2 verse 7, say what our priestly is supposed to be, keeping him knowledge. Supposed to be keeping the truth, and you know, not sometime but all the time,
and no lies.
You understand? Oh yes. So with that, I want to say shalom to the hope for the elect out there, you know, and just hope that this little thing we do here was edifying to the brothers.
Yeah.
So you say shalom.
Shalom. Kalalalwa, how would lie about Shemiyoshai?